हरे कृष्णा।
Hari Hari, kabe mor hoi beshodi, Hari Hari, kabe mor hoi beshodi.
স্বরে রাধিকা গোবিন্দ বলি কাঁদিব উচ্চ স্বরে রাধিকা গোবিন্দ বলি কাঁদিব উচ্চ স্বরে রাধিকা গো কাঁদিব উচ্চ স্বরে ভিজিবে সকল অঙ্গ নয়নে রণীরে
কলায়ঙ্গ নয়নের ভিজিবে কলায়ঙ্গ নয়নের এইবার করুণা কর রূপ সনাতন রূপ সনা রঘুনাথ দাস মোর শ্রীজীব জীব রুণা কর ললিতা বিষাদ আর সখ ভাবে সীতাম খ ভাবে সীতাম সু বনয়াদি আজি সবে মিলি কর দয়া সবে মিলি কর দয়া পুরক মর দয়া পুরক মর আস কৃষ্ণ হরে হরে হম রাম রাম হরে 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 রাম হরে হরে কৃষ্ণ 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 হরে 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 কৃষ্ণ হরে রাম হরে রাম রাম হরে রাম হরে রাম 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 এই হরে কৃষ্ণ হরে কৃষ্ণ হরে কৃষ্ণ নিতাই গৌর গৌর প্রমানন্দে হরি হরি
একটু দূরে যা তসমৈ বংশাকল্পতরুভ্যশ্চ কৃপাসিন্ধুভ্যৈব চ পতিতানাং পাবনেভ্যো বৈষ্ণবেভ্যো নমো মহাবদন্নায় কৃষ্ণপ্রেমভ্যায় কৃষ্ণায় কৃষ্ণচৈতন্য নাম্নে গৌরদ্ভিজে গুরবে গৌরচন্দ্রায় রাধিকায়ৈ তদালয়ে কৃষ্ণায় কৃষ্ণভক্তায় তদ্ভক্তায় নমঃ ভক্তিবিহীনায় অপরাধলক্ষ্যৈ ক্ষিপ্তাশ্চ কামাদিতরঙ্গমধ্যে কৃপাময়ীং ত্বাং শরণং প্রপন্না বন্দে নমস্তে চরণায় তবৈবাস্মি তবৈবাস্মি ন জুয়ামি তয়া বিনা ইতি বিজ্ঞায় রাধে তং নয় মাম চরণান্তি अनर्पित चरिं चिरात करुणयावतीर्ण कलु समर्पयितुम् उन्नतोज्ज्वलरसां स्वभक्तिसिं बाई अनकंडीशनल मर्सी चैतन्य महाप्रभु हैज कम टू दिस वर्ल्ड ही हैज कम टू गिव उन्नत उज्ज्वल रस श्रीय एंड आई वाज एक्सप्लेनिंग दैट व्हाट इज उन्नत उज्ज्वल रस आई एक्सप्लेन दैट दो द love and affection and services to Krishna from friends, from his mother Yashoda and Nanda Baba father, so much high, but it is not Unnat Ujjwala Rasa. The love and affection of Satyabhama and Rukmini is so high, but still it is not called Unnat Ujjwala Rasa. I told the pastimes of Srimad Bhagavatam about Rukmini, how he used to love Krishna, giving his heart and everything totally. But his affection and love was not so highest as the love and affection of gopis. Now I am giving an example from Srimad Bhagavatam, how Satyabhama was dearest and beloved of Krishna. But still, his love and affection is not called. Once, Krishna was sitting in the assembly of all the queens were there. Some were fanning him, some were giving chamar, some another service, all were serving Krishna. And in the meantime, Narada Rishi came with a parijat flower from heaven, so beautiful, so fragrant. This one flower made whole Dwarka Puri fragrance. He came, at once he was praying to Krishna that, I'm giving these flowers to you. And in front of me just now, you should give to any of your queen which you beloved, love much. Who is the your favorite. Best beloved?
Favorite.
You can give in their hands. Krishna was thinking that Narada is so jolly and he is so tricky. He always wants to make any problem. Now if I am going to give this flower to any of my queen, so many problems. All will be upset and they will be opposite of me. So why Narada came and in front of her, all his gift, telling me to give, to take and to give any one of his queen. What to do? But Narada was repeatedly telling him, that I want to see that you should give in my front and I will be so happy. Krishna saw that there is no any other means. I cannot cheat Narad because Narad is so so qualified in cheating all others. So he took it and began to saw towards the beautiful queens. All were at knowing that Krishna loves me more than anyone, all of them. Because always Krishna, to whom he used to meet, he used to tell that, you are my dearest queen. So all were thinking that Krishna will give to me only, not to anyone else. But Krishna, anyhow, he took it and he gave it to in the hands of Rukmini. Seeing this, Rukmini became so much happy and thought that I am beloved of Krishna more and I am so fortunate to have affection for Krishna. Now it is clear that I am
most favorite.
And I am highest in all the queens. All the kings' mouth became fed, especially Satyabhama. Became like a very poisonous
snake.
Lady snake. If anyone touch with a stick or anything, disturbs. Like this, she became and began to hiss. Krishna, Narada Rishi was so happy and he was testing all these things. But Krishna, he became, there is a very big problem. Narada has created this. So now he was thinking what to do. So all were unhappy except Rukmini, but especially Satyabhama was so furious, became she, that he could not check her heart. And anyhow, some symptoms that she is some crude anger, she could not
check.
She at once went from there, giving up all the samaj,
assembly.
And she took off his very beautiful garments, royal dresses,
ornaments,
everything. And he went in the anger room. In India, all the kings had some Kopa Bhavan in an anger room. If anyone has some man,
Sulky mood.
They used to give up their garments all and take some
worn and torn clothes,
dirty, and to go in the that room. Sitting or lying on the ground only, not in palanka, and lamenting and weeping. Then if the king will hear, then he will come and satisfy. So Satyabhama went there, gave him all the royal dresses, all the ornaments, and she was now weeping loudly, taking so much long breaths. And she was at that time so furious. Krishna also told that it is a very big problem, and he left that
assembly.
And he went, he followed where Satyabhama was, lying down on the earth and repenting. She was lying down and Krishna came very silently, and he sat by her side and he wanted to give his hands like but he see at once like furious
snake,
lady snake, she did like so that Krishna hands were pushed. But even Krishna has so many realized all these things, and he is so
expert
in all these things, being in Vrindavan with gopis. It was nothing for Krishna to satisfy Srimati Satyabhama. He used to satisfy Srimati Radhika, pacify Radhika. Even here he had no flute. Do you know why? Because their anger is not so high that I will have to use bansi here. By doing so, it will go away. And if I will be anger also, get out from my palace, I don't want to see your face, then automatically it will come down. But for gopis, Krishna cannot tell like this, because they are not living in the palace of Krishna. Krishna is not supporting any gopi, not giving anything to eat or anything. They are not subordinate to Krishna in any way. They are as swatantra,
independent
as Krishna is. But they can chastise Krishna also. Krishna cannot do that. Go away from my home. They will tell, I don't take anything from you. You are not giving me clothes and anything else. So you can go out of our punjas. If Krishna cannot specify them, that they can take the help of Lalita and Vishakha. If they are failed also, he will take the help of Subal. If he is failed, then he will take his bansi and make a very, very karuna rush from his throat. Karuna means pathetic tone. I cannot live without you, he will tell in there. And I am dying, and at once Sri Radhika will come. Anyhow, by Krishna behavior, Srimati was so much like anger, like that is man. And he was not meeting with Krishna. So many days passed. Krishna was so much repenting and wanted to such a skill how to specify. So he took shelter in the lotus feet of Vishakha and Lalita, and they told something in the ears of Krishna, and Krishna followed. Krishna came in the shape of a student, having some pothi here. Pothi means any book here. Sacred thread, wooden sandal, and some umbrella of any lips, palm leaves. And he came there. He was telling that I am a Brahmachari, Shishya of Gargacharya. I can wait for alms only for 1 minute. When a cow is milked in the such a time I can give. Otherwise I will go. If I am going barren, empty-handed, then so much sufferings and calamities may come. It may be that cows will die. It may be the master of cows and house will die. So he was coming to the house of the mother-in-law of Srimati Radhika in Jawat, crying, Alak Niranjan, Alak Niranjan, Alak Niranjan. Those are Mayavadi sannyasi, they do like this. Alak Niranjan, Alak Niranjan. Alak Niranjan means shouting the name of Brahma, who is shapeless, having no attributes, no power, nothing. Nirgun, just like Nirgun Brahma, Alak Niranjan. Her sister, mother-in-law saw that, a very beautiful, like son, a Brahmin, a student, asking for or begging something. In the morning he is there. She wanted to give, but he denied to take anything from her hands. Whether you are married, not married,
widow
or what thing, I don't know. So, if any chaste lady having the symptoms that she is married, I can take something. She went in the house and told Srimati Radhika, dear daughter, I am praying you, a very powerful, like son, a yogi has come, a student, and like rays are coming from him. So don't disobey, don't dishonor. Take some alms and give it to that Brahman, a student. He is perhaps the a student of
Gargacharya.
And he looks like so pandit
scholar.
Scholar also in Vedas and all. She refused, I cannot go to anyone who is so much, if he is so much
scholar.
A scholar or beautiful or yogi or anything, because he always
blaming me,
that you are speaking with so many boys and others. So I cannot go. Totally refused. Again and again she was
requesting
her, but she was not ready. Then he told to Lalita and Vishakha, she is not obeying me. But if she is not going to give alms to that boy, then all cows will die. And my son Abhimanyu will also die. So you should help me. Then they both went to Srimati Radhika. You should follow your mother-in-law words. You should go and give alms. Anyhow, by Vishakha and
Lalita.
She took some grains, golden coins, and so many things, you know, atta means
flowers
and all things in his golden pot. And in a golden pot, keeping his bell up to here, so that anyone cannot see his face. Very slowly, taking the help of his sakhis, she came out of his room where he was standing. He wanted to give that owl in the what? Jholi. Bag. Not bag. Krishna has made his clothes like this. She wanted to give, but Krishna refused. I cannot take it. I have come for so much distance, far away.
Far away.
Only to bear your anger in my this cloth. If you are smiling and give your anger, then I will be satisfied. Otherwise, I will die. She smiled some very little smile and she gave that pot on the head of Krishna, everything. Not in jholi, but on the head of Krishna. And she at once returned with his sakhis. Sakhis were laughing, all were laughing. And Krishna was satisfied. He had to pacify Srimati Radhika or gopis. Krishna has to do so many things. Bansi fell, Lalita Vishakha fell, Siddham Subal all fell, Krishna fell. Then he had to discover anything else to pacify them. He had no use of Bansi float, no use of taking help of Vishakha and all gopis, Subal Siddham. Only he is chastising to them is enough for them.
Threatening.
But now he is not, it is a last
help.
Ye antim unka astra hoga. His last
weapon.
He anyhow told very mildly that why you are so angry? It is only a flower. I will give you whole tree with full of flowers and I will plant in your courtyard. So don't be so worried. She told, I don't want, go away from here. I don't want. You are lie person.
Liar.
You are liar. You are cheater. We cannot believe you. To each and to me, several times you have told that you are my beloved, most beloved in all. But I have seen you. Only you tell like this, but never follow. You cheat all. Krishna, I am not cheating you. Have a faith on me. You can test me. Again, give a chance. So, yes, I am giving you one chance more. If you can plant, as you have told that Parijat tree in my courtyard and full of
flowers,
then I will help you. So come on and sit on the Garuda, on the back of Garuda. And he also sat there. And in the way he killed Narakasura. No? And then he proceeded towards heaven.
Indra.
He went in heaven. And he told to Indra, you always tell that I am your friend. So I want one tree of Parijat. I will take it to earth and I will plant in the courtyard of Satyabhama. please be pleased with me and give me one tree of Nandan Kanan. Nandan Kanan is full of Parijat trees. He told that, oh, I see that you have so dared to tell me the like so. Get out from heaven and go to earth at once. Parijat tree cannot be given. What to Parijat tree? Even a flower cannot be given to worldly persons. At once return from here. How you came here? Any person cannot come here without doing astrology for lakhs and lakhs years. You should go. And don't want this. Krishna told that I have come here to take that tree. I will uproot and take it with me there.
At that time Kirtan was going on heaven, so you are Kirtan here.
So he refused totally. Then Krishna went in on this back of Garuda to Nandan Kanan. He uprooted one tree and he was returning to Dwarka. But in the midway, Indra with his all soldiers, with his son and all others, attacked Krishna to take away that tree. But at last Krishna defeated them all. At this same time, the son of
Indra Jayanta,
Krishna, Pradyumna came. He defeated the son of Indra,
Jayanta,
and Krishna defeated Indra and all his soldiers. And he returned to Dwarka. And there he called all the
queens
there in the home of Satyabhama, and in front of them he planted that tree in the garden of Satyabhama. Satyabhama was so happy now, and he was trying to honor all the queens. But if a flower gave Krishna to Rukmini and Satyabhama was displeased, and all are coming to his home and tree was given to Satyabhama, was planted in the house, what will be the condition of all the queens? Rukmini is there, but she is so grave. She also thinking that, oh, Krishna is making more plays and Satyabhama is more beloved to Krishna, but she is not telling anything, and anything was not came out from his, any system,
symptom
from his body. He was so great. Here, we see some envy. There, in Dwarka, there is no chance of any bhav. But it is a class of aprakrita prema.
Transcendental love.
Transcendental love. To make Krishna please there. So highest class of love and affection and services to Krishna is there. But even the mood and affection of Satyabhama is not unnata ujjvala. Only the mood of gopis. You know, there are so many kinds of gopis. Siddha, Kai view of Krishna, of Aradhika. Some Nitya Siddha, some sadhana siddha. So many gopis are there. In sadhana, there are sruti-chari coming from sruti mantra. Jauthaki coming in jyuth, jyuth means in
group.
Coming in one or dual.
One or two.
Ajauthaki.
Individuals.
Coming sadhana siddha from Janakpuri. Coming from Dandakaranya. Rishichari, Munichari, Rishichari, Srutichari. These are all sadhana siddha. They are given of their anger, lust, worldly desires. When they were doing sadhana in their past lives, at the time of their sadhana avastha,
Sadhana avastha, you know?
In beginning, they are given. So, they gradually, they received nishtha, then ruchi, and then asakti, and gradually shuddha satta. From the heart of ragatmik gopis. No? Very, very rare. Yeah. Kitna baje? Kitna samay?
10 after 7.
Achha. So you can do a kirtan. Oh, any kirtan. Any kirtan, mahamantra or anything. Yesterday your kirtan of mahamantra in that tone was so good.
Same.
Very good. Where is khol, mridanga? We'll be right back. no worldly desire, worldly pain, suffering, sorrow, anything. They don't know. Because they have crossed all these things in the age of sadhana, bhava, and prema also. Now they have prema. So they have taken birth in Braja. Who are sadhana siddha? The Kayabhu of Radhika, those gopis who are Kayabhu of Radhika. Expansion of Srimati Radhika. They went direct in the ras. They go. Yogmaya always makes arrangements to go there. No problems, nothing, obstacles. Also, Nitya Siddha, they also go. No disturbance, no problem for them. Only Sadhana Siddha gopis, in the past life, they have done the puja of Katyayani to have husband, Krishna, praying to Katyayani. Katyayani, Mahamaya, Mahajoginadhishwari, Nanda Gopasutam,
Devi,
Patime Kurute Namaha. We want that you should give us benediction that Krishna should be my husband. So they became in their birth of when they came in Braja by the womb of any gopi. And they were married to any gopi. But hearing the glories of Krishna, sometimes hearing the float of Krishna from others, they have so much affection of Krishna to meet Krishna. The day when they heard the Venunad,
sound of the flute,
they were going to meet Krishna, but their husband stopped. To whom? Sadhana Siddha gopis, who have come recently and taken birth there. There are so many sadhana siddha mixing with nitya siddha gopis, they have gone very easily there. No restriction, nothing. Only for those who have recently and were married, and they may have some children also, they were checked. Because the ladies who have some children and they have some relation with their husband, they cannot go there. Though they were checked there. Why they are checked? There was something which should go away. So, when they were checked there, they were so much feeling for separation. Separation like fire.
Burning fire of separation.
And in that burning fire, there's something which was ashubha.
Unfavorable.
It burned. And in their remembrance, in their meditation, they took Krishna in their heart and so much
strongly embraced hugging
that in Milan,
unity,
in meeting with Krishna, something which were auspicious thing for them, it also was
materially auspicious.
What it was? not any material things, nothing material desire or anything. What were Shubh and Ashubh? Pious and unpious. What these things were there? Gopi was not burnt. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur and all our Acharya have told that. Any one of Gopi was not burnt. But their mood, which was unpious or pious activities, were burnt. Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, to whom he met, like Jagai and Madai, he did not cut their heads. No one was used, no chakra, nothing. Only their mood were
changed.
But they became in new life, not past life. Because everything sinful activities or good activities were burned. You should also think, should understand, any worldly pious or unpious, both activities are bindings. They will disturb in service of Krishna. So sadhak in their sadhana stage, everything goes away. Bad activities and good activities. In Sanskrit they are called pap evam punya. The fruit of bad activities is pap. What is pap?
Sins.
And the good activities, punya, pious activities. If both are there, you will have to take birth again and again. So you will have to give up both things. Then it will be asakti and after that it will bhav. But gopis has crossed all these stages and they have come in the womb of gopis. No? So what was burnt? If there is no good and pious, pious and bad activities, punya or
pap,
then what was burnt there? Being there. In past life, they have so much austerities for Katyayanis that Krishna should be our husband. It is absurd to go in Braj in the mood of husband taking Krishna. Understand?
Yes.
Not?
Yes. Say it again, please.
Swakiya.
It is Swakiya Bhav. Yes. All the Rajkumaris of Janakapur, when Ram went to Janakapur, they saw the beauty of Ram. And so much attracted. When they saw that Ram is marrying with
Sita,
they became so much happy, but still there was something lacking there. What lacking? Why we are not given marriage to Ram? We want to be
husband.
That Ram should be my husband and wife of Ram. We should try, we want to be married with Krishna. Ram was himself God. No? He also Krishna. Manifestation of Krishna, Swarup of Krishna. He is not other than Krishna. So he took all their modes in him and told that in this life I cannot make you
my wives.
I cannot marry. But internally, I have adopted you. I have
accepted
you. We'll have to wait for this. for next birth. I'm telling my Yogmaya to give a birth in the womb of Gopi there. And there, when you will be young, you will have the association of Nitya Siddhar Kai Vivaha for Radhika, Sakhis. Then you will be qualified to be my beloved there, and you enjoy all these things there. So this mood was something in their hearts, that he should marry her husband. But why they went to the womb of gopis? Because Ram has told like so, that promise that you will be my beloved there. So they are waiting only for this thing, that husband mood should go away. And this is past thing. But even it was problem for them, that this should not go away. So from Sakya there will be Parkiya Bhava. Parkiya Bhava was not in them at that time. They wanted to love Krishna, but their chastity was problem for them. There was no problem from Nitya Siddha or all these gopis. But there was some problem in newly coming and having birth in there. They have never met with Krishna. Only from far away they may see. Or they have come by marriage newly, 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, 1 year, 2 years in Braja. They are from Indraprastha. They may be of other parts of Braja, and they have come to Nandagaon. They have come to Jawat by marriage. They want to love, but they cannot love. They cannot freely meet to Krishna, because this was a big problem for them. So when they took Krishna in their
heart,
and they strongly embraced at once this pure thing,
impurity.
Secondly, there are some children and they have met with their husband, so they cannot go with Krishna. Those who have any affection for a little bit to their children and husband, that he is my husband, they cannot go. Any gopis, why, you know, all the gopis had no connection with their husbands. When they were becoming young to be married, Yogmaya at once did a trick. She called up Brahma, and she came in the mind of Brahma that I want to see some
magic,
some pastimes of Krishna, whether he is Krishna or not. He wanted, if we can stole the cocks and cowherd boy from Krishna, what he does? So he skillfully stolen away all the cowherd boys and also cocks also, and kept in the
cave.
And for 1 year he was waiting to see what he is doing. But Krishna, as usual, he made himself lakhs and lakhs of cups and
cowherd boys.
And daily he used to play like usual, as if nothing has been
happened.
Nothing has happened. At last Brahma, at the last day he came and saw that, what is strange is there? I know you all what happened. Krishna has mercy to him. To arise that all the cops and friends were himself Krishna. Why? because all the cows and mother of Braja wanted that Krishna should be their son. No? They wanted. So Krishna must fulfill this idea. And another reason was that more important, that all the ladies, all the girls of Braja wanted that Krishna should be our husband, our beloved. So Krishna became in thousands and lakhs
covered by,
but not in his shape, but
their shape.
Their shape. And all were married
to him.
To whom they were married? Actually to Krishna, but not in that shape, in Krishna shape. So all were. But those who have no association of Nitya Siddha or even Sadhan Siddha, who were senior, they have no. So those two things were there. That I explained. So, good activities and bad activities. So, that was, they have some tendency that Krishna should be my husband. But they cannot come, those who have, they will have to go to Dwarka. But Ramchandra, unconditional, merciful, he gets this chance to them. So both were burned. So don't try to make any pious activities or bad activities. Try to serve Krishna by all your activities. Don't do karma. If you are doing anything for yourself or for others to please and to good for them, then it will be good activities. It will be problem for you. If you are making a temple to show that I am doing so big thing, I am a dwar of this mandir, so much name and fame will come, and this will be very problem for that person. Don't do these things. Only to please Krishna or devotees or Gurudev. In some occasion you can do. Otherwise they will all be like a problem. Only their problem was that Krishna should be our husband. So it was problem. But Krishna was so merciful, and all gopis, by the association, everything was gone. But if in the sadhana avastha, you will have so many things, then your sadhana is vyartha.
In vain.
Hampered. We will go to either of Vaikuntha. If it is successful, then you can go to
Vaikuntha,
or you can go to Dwarka. You cannot go to Braja. So he is now explaining what is sadhan. Sadhan. We are not acquainted with what is sadhan. Only you chant sometimes 8 round Harinam with so many worldly desires, having so many gains, with so many anarths, not knowing that what is love and affection and what is called sadhan bhajan. Doing only that Guru has told that you should do chant Harinam, and by chanting this Harinam, everything will be done. He has told correct by doing Harinam. But Harinam should be But
pure.
With a relation. Give him all the worldly desires, all the anarths, aparad and everything. Even that Krishna should be or has been. Everything. Then it will be sadhana. You have known that anna vilasita sunya jnana karma adi anabhritam anukulena krishna anusilanam bhakti. All kinds of worldly desires, all kinds of Vaikuntha desire also, all desires for Dwarka also, every should be given up. Know all these desires. Don't take the help of karma and jnana so much. Don't cover your bhakti with karma and jnana. Don't have any abhilasha.
Desire.
Only to please Krishna and Krishna bhakti. To have pure bhakti, you can have desire. Nothing else. And always by tan, man, vachan. By
mind and man.
And by moods, in vritti atmak and pravritti atmak. No? What is pravritti? Doing all the efforts by tan, man, vachan, by body, mind and
words.
And don't do anything against bhakti. This is nivritti atmak. Don't anything. Do which is obstacle for bhakti. Then this is called sadhana. That is why he is telling Kriti Shadhya Bhaveta Shadhya Bhava Sarsadhana Vida Nitya Siddhasya Bhavasya Prakatyam Haridisha. I will explain it tomorrow. Try to remember what I have told. All the Siddhanta. So gravely in your heart that you should be qualified to understand it. Where you are not understanding, you can question from senior Vaishnavas here, those who have understood. And if you are not satisfied, then come to me with a question, I will try to solve. This is a very good occasion. We are all discussing all these things, highest thing. If you lose this time, you will lose forever. Mm. It is very rare to have these associations, no? So try to make it successful. Don't lose a word even. And then you will see that you have so much good bhakti. So I will explain tomorrow. Gaur Premanande Bhakti Devi Ki
Jai.
I don't do it. If you do, then all evils will come.
Thank you. Oh.